This is our record we got coming out here in Germany. On one side we got Too Much to Dream, and this is the other side. It's called If You Don't Wanna Fuck Me, Baby, Fuck Off. Then honey, you can just get the hell out of my bread line.
the right time. In the night time. When it's the right time. I wanna be with you. In the night time. In the night time. Cause the night time is the right time.
Thank you.
man and not the guitar. But they say I'm a fool. I let you treat me so cruel. But you know it's the game. Out of everything you say, I took the heart to play. Honey, buddy,
I'm a little bit of a slap. I'm a little bit of a slap. I'm a little bit of a slap.
from our new album called Storm the Gates of Heaven. I'm coming. A track called Are You Man Enough to Be a Woman?
Just like a robot, just
This next one is from our first album called The Electric Chairs. And it's called You May Look Cool, Baby, But You Is Bad in Bed.
Last night. Max's Kansas City album. It is. Called You Make Me Cream in My Jeans. You buy. Oh, can't you see the gleam in my eye? You make me cream in my jeans. You make me cream in my jeans. You make me cream in my jeans. I try so hard to run away. You make me do every single day. You make me cream in my jeans. I try and I try, it's just no use. Try to break away, I can't get you loose. Keep trying, you got me cheese. Every time, it took about the first time. You make me cream in my jeans. You make me cream in my jeans. Every time, I face you back. Oh, can't you see? Cream in my eye. You make me cream in my jeans. You make me cream in my jeans. You make me cream in my jeans. You're making it great and not you. All right. It's raining now. This is about a club in New York City called Nexus, Kansas City.
Yeah.
This next song is another track off our first album, Plug Plug Plug. And this is a song is about some dead rock and roll stars from the 60s. And it's called Rock and Roll Resurrection.
The blood. Out of control, the whole damn world is out of control. combination of dirty, sexually obsessed lyrics and demented stage antics, not unlike my own program, my next guest took the New York rock scene by storm in the early 70s to become the first transsexual rock star. Here to discuss her autobiography, Man Enough to Be a Woman. Please would you welcome the rock and roll Cleopatra herself, hopefully not too much for colour television, formerly Wayne, now Jane County.
Yeah! You got my chin, that's very bad.
Jane, that's lovely. Would you like the soft focus, darling, or not? Or would you go for it full frontal?
I think I do need the soft focus.
Do you think so? Please, please come here, join me.
Got
join me.
Can now, I get close to you?
Now listen, please come as close as you like. Come as close. Look, reading the book, I'm surprised you're still on this planet. To be, I mean, after the life you've led in this book, I'm surprised you actually are still here. Sex, often drugs, rock and roll,
and rednecks.
Abuse and rednecks. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, the truth of the matter is, in the early days. When I was exploring my transgender identity in Atlanta, Georgia, we had to learn how to run very fast. It wasn't just the rednecks who was after us, it was the police as well.
I mean, are they as bad as you make out those guys down there?
It was pretty bad in the 60s, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, we had to hide behind trees. You know. We'd hide behind, there'd be a police car coming down the street, and we had a nickname. We'd say, Alice Bluegown is coming, Alice Bluegown is coming. We'd stand behind a tree, and as the cop car would drive like this. We'd be behind the tree, sort of doing like this as the car came around the tree. You know, so they would arrest you. Now, in Atlanta in the 60s, they had a law that said if your hair touched the tip of your ears, if a man's hair touched the tip of his ears, he could be arrested for female impersonation.
Really? So you moved to New York around
yes,
that time?
Yes, we were always getting arrested and having our heads shaved.
What was New York like?
Oh, New York was a revelation.
In fact, you bumped into Andy Warhol, or you actually engineered the meeting, or what?
Well, I was hanging out at Max's Kansas City, which is a famous New York underground haunt. Mm. And Andy Warhol used to hang out there along with the Velvet Underground and the New York Dolls. All sorts of people would walk in, Janis Joplin, Jimi Hendrix, everyone in the world. But also hanging out there would be like art dealers, drug dealers, speed freaks mixing, you know, low life mixing with supposedly high life.
At this time, you were still a man?
I was.
Or still a kind of man's bits, anyway?
I was considered male.
Yeah.
But it was a very debatable question in everyone's eyes at the time, I think.
Did you think of yourself as a woman then?
Yeah, I did. Yeah.
Now, you took part in the. You were in Andy Warhol's film Pork. Which was an interesting thing.
Stage production, yeah.
Which got quite a lot of bad press, didn't it, one way
or another? When we came to England, we played the Roundhouse. We got a lot of bad press because one of the girls in the play, she had this act where she comes out and when she would twirl these little twirls on the tips of her thingies, right? Yeah, and for publicity, she went up to Buckingham Palace and stood in front of Buckingham Palace and did her act and was arrested.
That's a shame. If she'd done it now, of course, they'd have all joined in. Yes.
So we got all this bad press, and everyone came down to heckle. But well, we had people coming down to cheer as well. We had loads of famous people. The audience loved us. The press hated us.
But the audience were there.
Every night.
Yeah, I mean, I'm trying to think. When I read through the book, I was amazed at some of the things you did. I mean, some of the you eating excrement on stage was. I mean, I can't believe
that's
you actually did that.
That's not true.
It's not true.
No, it was dog food.
Ah, oh, right, okay. It was dog food.
Yeah.
You were dressed as a human wig at the time.
For one part of the show, I was dressed as a human wig. Another part of the show, I was dressed as a garbage dump.
Yeah. A garbage dump?
Yeah, a garbage dump. Yeah, I wore garbage. Yeah. Another part of the show, I sat on a toilet and I pretended to duty. It wasn't real duty, it was Alpo dog food.
Uh-huh.
And, by this time, a lot of times, the whole place would be empty anyway, so people would run in horror, dragging their boyfriends out. This is sick. Don't look at her. Don't look at her. At least they said her.
1977, you relocated to London. You'd had enough of all that.
Yeah.
Was it before that that you went to Berlin?
I've been going back and forth to Berlin for many years, you know. The punk thing in London was more better for me. It was more showy.
Yeah.
the rips, the safety pins, the leftover David Bowie eye makeup, you know, from the glam period, the spiky hair. The New York thing was more arty.
Now, when you went to, I mean, you don't mind because you've written it in the book, when you went to Berlin, you started working in a transvestite whorehouse for a while.
Yes, that was very interesting.
Doing tricks. What made you actually, a serious point, not a joke, you actually went there, you gave all this up, and you decided to become a whore. Why?
Well, I didn't actually decide to become a whore, but I had sort of, I was pinching my pennies at the time, and I needed a new wardrobe. Not pinching my penny, my pennies. Pennies. Yeah. I have two, darling.
He's always on about them, don't worry.
I know.
So, I mean, what was it like working with? What sort of guys that came in there? Did you sort of?
They were usually guys that were, believe it or not, I explained this in the book, most of them were married, and they would sneak off for a little time with a transsexual. The whole thing was to get the money and to do as little as possible.
Did you do as little as possible?
Oh, yes, as little as possible. We'd move the clocks up an hour.
Really?
And then we'd start screaming, your wife is going to kill you if you don't get home, you know.
There's a lot of heartache in the book, and there's also, that you sort of pour yourself out, and you obviously there's quite a lot of sadness. Is the sadness still there or not?
No, I don't. Where is that in the book?
Well, it came across to me that you know, you were quite sad. Underneath it all the bravado and everything else, you felt that people had given you a hard time.
Not really a hard time. You know, you have to lift your head above it. I mean, sure, you could get hassle in the streets from people. You know,
could you go back to your hometown, for instance?
Yeah, I went back.
I went back.
Yes.
Because now you're a woman. You're a complete transsexual now.
No, I decided at the last moment not to have the full sex change. Mm. I had reached my level of transsexualism, and I didn't feel it was necessary to get the whole sex change.
What about the future after the book? You've got a CD out, and will you be back performing or not?
I am performing. I'm doing a tour here in England, playing all over Scotland as well. I have a new CD out called Deviation, a part two compilation album, Let Your Backbone Slip, and of course my book, Are You Man Enough to Be a Woman?
Jane County, it's a fascinating book, and thank you for talking to us about it. Ladies and gentlemen, Jane County! Actually, just before we finish, hang on, I tell you, I had to ask you. There was a bit in the book, and they said, you wouldn't tell me anyway, but they said there was a night up in the north of England, you and a football team, that you didn't mention the name of this football team. Was that true?
It wasn't in the north of England, it was a northern team. I'd get in trouble.
Yes, okay, fine. Right. But it's interesting, isn't it? Baz wants to talk to you later about it. Was it the whole team or not?
There was an incident with two northern football teams, actually.
Oh, two football teams?
you did all 22?
Yes, okay, fine. Jane, it's a fascinating book. And people, if they didn't know that it was true and you hadn't come here, they wouldn't believe it. No. They just wouldn't believe it. Thank you very much indeed, ladies and gentlemen, again for Jane County. Hey!